Time for the big three. Three stocks, three charts, three trades. Ben Lichtenstein will take us through the charts. Here to take us through the trades, Joe Tigay, portfolio manager of the Rational Equity Armor Fund. Good to see you both. Thanks for being here. Joe, before I get to Meta, just a big picture on, you know, where we stand here with the markets, what trends you're watching.
Yeah, so we're a week past the CPI, a week past the Fed. The market really rallied through those two events, maybe better than expected headline number on CPI, but the core number, people might not realize was not as good as the market might give it credit for. And also the Fed was very hawkish. The market was not looking for two more hikes coming this year. And in spite of all that, the market has still managed to rally over the past week. We've maybe slowing down in the past couple of days, but the market still charged ahead and really still fueled by primarily the same story, which is AI pushing us forward. Seven stocks in the S&P 500 are up 55%, while the other 493 right now, as we're speaking, are flat on the year.
All right. So there's been a lot of optimism surrounding AI and tech, and a name like Meta, for example, which is up 135% this year. And I'll put the cage fight with Zuckerberg and Elon Musk aside. I mean, it's just fascinating. They're just such brand. They're so good at branding. One is a sumo expert and one is a jiu-jitsu expert. I can't. Okay, Meta platforms. Joe?
Wait, I did not know Musk was a sumo expert. I had heard, never mind. Meta's been on a fantastic run this year. I've been on the big three again and again, I think three times now, saying I'm buying a call spread in Meta, just expecting more upside. Right now, as we sit, we've had this tremendous run. It seems like things are starting to just maybe consolidate here. I want to see some more consolidation. I'm going to shift from a call spread, which I've been buying. I'm going to sell a put spread. Now, I still has a bullish slant selling a put spread, same as buying a call spread, but I'm not looking as the same like type of growth over the next month or so. And again, this will also be profitable if Meta does consolidate and even come in for me. And this is a very conservative put spread. Right now, Meta's over 280. I'm selling the 260, 240 put spread in August. Plenty of room if Meta does have a little correction between here and there. I'm going to collect about $2 to do so while I'm just going to wait a couple months out, see what happens next. I think some consolidation is in order for the big names here, especially Meta.
Right, and we should give you credit because this has gone from $88 to $287, an incredible run. Ben Lichtenstein, take a look at the Meta Platforms chart.
Nicole, I like this approach because we are seeing something a little bit more resemblant of a consolidation, overlapping, rotational type price activity relative to the strong run-up that we had seen. Looking at the chart, you'll see that right away. I mean, you've got the big move up on the left side of your screen here for the most part, but the right half here is really just overlapping and a bit more rotational, right? We're looking at 5-minute candles here. You can see a few areas of consolidation that formed over the last couple weeks, 265, 270, 271, currently balancing around 282 right now. But while we are seeing something a little bit more overlapping and rotational, again, with that bullish also stance here, you can see why, because we've seen migration of value to the upside going back to the lows that we saw beginning of March, end of February, down around 167. So yeah, we're starting to lose some of that momentum to the upside, a little bit more overlapping and rotational, but we still have not invalidated the working assumption that we're forming value areas at higher and higher levels. Currently balancing around 282. As long as we remain above 266, the idea is that we're going to eventually see another one, continuation more likely than change, right? The trend is your friend. And again, no rejection as of yet. Look where we are relative to the 50, the 200-day moving average. I think it's tough to sustain this type of momentum to the upside. So I have to agree with this approach. It's a somewhat neutral to bullish, which I think price activity is supportive of.
All right. Thank you for that. And, you know, and look, I mean, when you look at those moving averages, that gap higher more than once, Joe, final thoughts on Meta. And is it Meta that you like? I mean, would you consider any of the other sort of the Magnificent Seven?
I think this approach might be warranted on some of the Magnificent Seven. It's more warranted on the names that have had the type of parabolic growth we've seen the past quarter, maybe NVIDIA, maybe Tesla, more so than the Googles. Microsoft, I think, would include in that group too, where I would consider a put spread also.
Right. Okay. Can we turn your attention over to Coinbase? Because what a run we've seen in crypto. I know they're not necessarily correlated. You also have BlackRock's big announcement about filing for a spot ETF for Bitcoin. What are your thoughts on Coinbase itself?
Yeah, Coinbase has really struggled this year. It's not really performing in the market rally like most of the stocks are not. Also, you look at the past quarter for crypto, it's kind of a mediocre quarter, of a bad quarter. Really, stocks, you know, equities were good, the NASDAQ was good. Usually you see these tech stocks and crypto performing a lot more correlated. However, the past week or so, yeah, big run up in Bitcoin. Yet Coinbase hasn't really moved yet. They have had some regulatory issues. We've all been watching what's been going on the exchanges the past year. So that's been holding it back. But I think if Bitcoin gets the legs, that usually will spread to the rest of the smaller coins. If that happens, I expect potential upside in Coinbase. So I'm just looking out in the very short term, going to look to play to that upside. Just look for a July 60-67 call spread. That would cost $2.05 right now.
Yeah, so going for that bullishness. I mean, people are talking about the halving of Bitcoin and seeing Bitcoin on the rise, moving to like the next stop is 41,000. There's been a lot of talk this week. So, Ben, what do you think about Coinbase today?
The words, he said it struggled, he said it's not performed. I completely agree with that. And it's not providing a very well-defined trend, nowhere near a stark contrast to what we just looked at in terms of Meta. Let's get into the 30-minute candles first. While we do not have a well-defined trend, we've got a pretty well-defined upper and lower extreme here that's been established over the last couple weeks. The highs from this month up around 66. You got the lows around 45. Do the math. You can see we're holding just above that pivot area, 56. Now, I'm kind of looking at 50 to 60 is a significant area. Let me show you why. As we step away from the 30-minute candles, you can see the four-hour chart, the candles. And this range has been in place for a while here. Now we're looking at 30 to 88. But again, a range-bound stock that hasn't provided a well-defined trend one way or the other throughout, well, all of this year. We're going all the way back to the middle of October last year. In this instance, we're talking about, again, 50 to 60 being a key area to keep an eye on in terms of a pivot area right now, and it's parked on that level, so no real lean here. I always say, when in doubt, zoom out. Unfortunately for the bulls, when you do that, well, this is what you're left with. Again, significance associated with the 55-60 area, somewhat pivotal, but a very well-defined downtrend here. So, again, underperformed, to say the least, struggled, yeah, but still in a downtrend. No rejection of these lower levels.
Yeah, I mean, it is tough to watch the sell-off that we have seen in this area. And so, Joe, what's your final thought? Because, you know, there was a lot of scrutiny from regulators. It's just, you know, the question is, what happens next, right?
Yeah, so Coinbase is different than a lot of the other exchanges, of course, U.S.-based. They have a lot more difficult rules along it. I think it's a better space than most of the other spots to put money when I'm looking at the crypto space. And crypto, for me, is just a trade in the short term. Bitcoin itself has had a nice run. I just want to piggyback off that. I'm expecting Coinbase to follow.
Understood. All right. How about Rivian? Love it, hate it. It's kind of that kind of stock. Your thoughts on Rivian these days?
Yeah, it's been a very volatile stock. It's been moving all around. People are expecting it to be the next Tesla. You know, it has a really nice story. It's very sleek looking car, but it really got hit hard when the U.S. government came out and said it's going to give $9.6 billion to Ford to in a loan to develop their electric batteries. So I didn't like that news. I think that's kind of cutting into its case. People were saying, oh, well, Tesla's got this EV thing cornered. Well, if Ford and the big three are going to get into it, it kind of cuts into the narrative that Rivian would be like the main competitor for Tesla. Anyways, I'm just looking short-term downside in Rivian. It already has come off some. I'm just going to look at August, looking at the 15-10 put spread. Rather than just going out there and short the name, I can get short it via options, and I'll know my risk that way. This trade will be $2.10. It'll be most I can lose, and it'll be a $5 spread. It'll be a $3 profit if it closes below 10.
Yeah, without a doubt. I mean, it's right off the 52-week lows of 1168. I had to look back. Remember when it was $179 and the IPO happened? I mean, there was so much hoopla surrounding this name. Ben, your thoughts on this chart of Rivian?
We'll have a look at the bigger picture in just a second, but I agree with the bearishness in terms of multiple time frames are seeing weakness. I just wanted to go back and look at the move lower we've seen since the middle of February. We're up around $21. You know, we were just talking a minute ago about the significance of the $50 to $60 range, and I want to point out here, as far as a similar pattern here, a situation playing out, we've got a significant level right around, if you take a look here, around 14. So you've got the high conviction move lower into the beginning of March. It's been mostly sideways since, moving away from the 30-minute candles. You can see a longer-term trend to the downside playing out on the four-hour candle chart from the middle of October last year, up around 37, down to, again, this consolidation area that's been forming since March around $14, similar to what we were just talking about in terms of the move lower here and some of the trend environment that we've been seeing. Look at this, a very similar situation here, as you can see, well-defined trend lower. You're talking about from 179, that high you mentioned, Nicole, back in the end of 2021, beginning of 2022, but well-defined trend lower, and the significance of the 14 area, again, on this chart, when you zoom out, not necessarily the picture the bulls are looking for here, that's for sure.
Yeah, understood. And thank you for all of that, Ben. Great charts, as always. You know, immediate and the big picture. We appreciate your perspective always. Joe Tigay, final thoughts here. As you take a look at Rivian, we've talked about how it's been beaten down, and you're still feeling bearish here.
Yeah, short term, look, feeling bearish. I think there's just too many headwinds out there for the stock.
Yeah, good to see you, Joe. Thank you
very much
for the big three. Joe Tigay, Rational Equity Armor Fund, and our own Ben Lichtenstein on the big three today. Thank you both. We looked at Meta, Coinbase, and Rivian.